By the end of this video, you will know how to change your avatar size, save it for your future use, and import it back into your CLO workspace quick and easy in CLO 3D. To change the avatar size in CLO 3D, first we're gonna select the avatar by go to the library panel, which is over here, and then double click on the avatar to open the folder below here. When you come down here and you see manage folder, you can view it as a folders icon or as a list. If you click on this list view, we'll change this interface to list view rather than icon view. I like to actually look in here with the icon view, so I'm gonna click it back to the icon view. We're gonna click on the female underscore v1, double click on it to open this folder. Then after you open the folder, you will see these avatars down here. So this one is Emma and this one is Kelly. For this tutorial, we are going to select fv1 underscore Kelly dot avt. As you can see, when you hover your mouse over the avatar itself, you will see the name to the right, and then double click on the avatar to open. So now the avatar is open. Again guys, you see I'm zooming in and zooming out. To zoom in, scroll your mouse wheel forward, and to zoom out, scroll your mouse wheel backward. And one more tip, guys. If you want to spin her around to the 360 degree view, press down Alt on your keyboard and right click on your mouse and then drag your mouse left to turn her to the left, drag it right to turn her to the right, and so on. Next, we're gonna open the avatar editor window. To do so, go to avatar in the menu, click on it to open the list below, and then you come down here to this avatar editor, click on it. Now this avatar editor window pop up. To change the sizes of the avatar, we're gonna type in this number in here. Okay, first of all, under this avatar editor we have three menus: avatar menu, major, arrangement. For this video, we are gonna just focusing on avatar size. And come down here, we have total body, we have detail, we have so and so. So to the right hand side here is very important, guys. Before you decide to enter any data in here, be sure to select the unit measurement that match what you desire. For example, since I'm using centimeter, I'm gonna stick with centimeter. And if you use inches or millimeter, however, just select one of those. Okay, so I'm gonna select centimeter, and everything in here gonna be centimeter. Okay, we want to change avatar size to petite size 6. This is really cool, guys. This Avalon form, they have this US standard size chart as well as the size chart from around the globe. What we're gonna do in this tutorial, I'm gonna share with you how to change the avatar from the original size to this petite curvy size 6. Okay, this size chart, it makes your job a lot easier. You need all the size 6 right here in this column. You have inches and you have centimeter. I'm gonna use all the centimeter sizes right here in this white column, and we're gonna use all the data in here except the head one. Okay, so we're gonna use neck space, across shoulder, etc. I'm gonna use this chart and I'm gonna come back to CLO, and we're gonna start type in as required for CLO to change a size. One more important thing that I want to point out. So right here, detail. You can select whether advanced human body for this purpose. I'm going to show you the basic one, okay? So you just select the basic one and then you're going to type in the data that's required. So based on the form, petite size 6, the total height for petite size 6 is 158.75 and press enter on your keyboard. You always press enter after you enter the data. And now we're going to go to bust circumference and highlight the text over. And we're going to type in and look at in the chart, we see bust circumference, which is 89.5, press enter. Then next, we're going to come down here and just scroll this, your mouse wheel around up and down to see more data below it, okay? So now we're going to go to neck base circumference. So neck base circumference, as soon as I highlight the box, you see on the 3D avatar, that yellow highlighted, it's really cool to appear on there, you know exactly where you change your sizes, okay? So neck base circumference, again, refer to the size chart. We're gonna look for neck base circumference. That is 36.25, press enter. Then next, I like enter the data from left to right. Next, we're gonna go to hip, okay? That is hip circumference. And we're gonna go to the side chart again, go to hip circumference. Hip circumference is 86.25. Press enter. Next, we're gonna go to low hip circumference, which is right below the high hip circumference in the side chart, okay? So lower hip circumference is 95.25. Again, highlight it and then type in the data. 95.25, press enter. Next. Again, come back over here after we change the neck and the hip. Now we're going to come to cross shoulder. Cross shoulder is 37.5, press enter. Now we're going to go to the right, which is under leg. We're going to highlight here, inseam. Okay, so inseam is 72.5. Press enter. After that, we're gonna go to thigh circumference. So thigh circumference is 55.25. Press enter. Now we're gonna come down here, CF next to, which is below it, CF neck to waist, and we're gonna highlight it, and we come to the side chart. CF neck to waist is 34.75. Press enter. So we did center front neck to waist, and now we're gonna continue with center back neck to waist. Highlight it and refer to the chart is 39. So we're gonna type in 39, then press enter. Okay, so after we finish the center back next to waist, now we continue to the arm. So under the arm is center back next to wrist. So we're gonna go to the side chart and we're gonna look for that. Center back next to wrist is 72.25, press enter. And next is bicep. Below center back next to wrist is bicep. And the bicep is 27.25. So 27.25, press enter. And now We're gonna come down here to the bus area. Since we already type in the bus up here already, we don't need to retype it. So now we're gonna come here to high point shoulder to epic. And so high point shoulder to epic in this chart is 25.5. So we're gonna type in 25.5, press enter. And now we come down here to waist circumference. Okay, again, we're gonna go to a size chart. The waist circumference is 73.75, press enter. And lastly, we have actual measurement, total right. Again, we're gonna highlight it and go to total right in our size chart. And the total right in the size chart for this is 62. We're gonna type in 62, press enter. Now, we are finished with alter the sizes. Now we're gonna save the avatar so we can use it later, okay? So to save the avatar, we're gonna go here. You see in the right corner here, if you hover the mouse over it, you see the save button, click on it. Then we're gonna name it. So I'm gonna name her Kelly Petite Size 6. And I'm gonna save her to my desktop. Kelly Petite Size 6. And I'm gonna click save to save it. Now I'm gonna come back to the window and then click on the X to close the editor window. And now we're gonna have to save this file as well. So come to file, click on it, and we want it to save as. Hover the mouse over save as, and then come down here, save as avatar, okay? And we're gonna name her the same as the file we saved earlier. So Kelly Petite Size 6. And then press save to save it. And recognize this up here, guys. We save it in CLO asset, okay? So the first one we save it in our desktop. This one we're gonna save it in CLO asset. Click save. Now the avatar is saved, all right? And because we already saved our avatar, and we're gonna quit it to close CLO. And I wanna show you how to import her back. So to bring the avatar back, first we're gonna go to click on CLO to open, then click on locking. Okay, so we are here in CLO workspace. We are going to bring our avatar, the one that we just altered, back in. So to do so, go to file, click on it, and then you see hover your mouse over this add. And then come to the right, click on the avatar. So here, Kelly Petite Size 6 avatar, click on it and come down here, click on the open button to open the avatar. And here she is. So while this gizmo still active, you can click on it and then move her anywhere you want in this workspace, or somehow you make a mistake and then you can't see the gizmo but anymore, and then you want to move her around. The only way to do it to go to this, you see this avatar symbol, and come over here to show x-ray join, click on it, and now you come down here, you see this kind of pinky look. Hover your mouse over it, click it, and now the gizmo active again. Now you can move her anywhere you want, as you desire. So next, I'm gonna turn that skeleton thing looking on. So come back over here and then just click on the show x-ray again and then turn her off, okay? So this is the avatar that we change the size to, which is Kelly Petite Size 6. Now we're gonna import the original avatar and we can compare them together, okay? To do so, go to File, Add, and then come down here to the avatar, click on it, and this time instead of select Kelly Petite Size 6, we want FV1 underscore Kelly dot AVT. Click on it and then click on the open button to open her and leave everything the way it is and then click OK. So while the gizmo is still active, click on her to move her to the side. Now we can compare both. So I'm going to actually open just a 3D window. To do so, you come down here, you see right here, just click on this 3D. And when you click on it, your 3D view come into like the full view. And we're gonna adjust this avatar over here to compare them together. Now, as you can see, the alter avatar is shorter than her. I assume she's size tall or messy, something like that. But her avatar is size 6 petite. Okay, the standard measurement chart that we use from Avalon.com. So to reset the window back to normal, come down here and you see this kind of undo button. It is reset layout and you click on it and reset back to 3D and 2D window as it was default. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. Now you have your avatar that you can use it anytime you want and you know how to save it and import it back to your CLO workspace. I hope this video useful. If you guys want to be notified, be sure to subscribe and click on the bell every time I upload a new learning video. You will get notified. See you for the next tutorial.